power generation. This is the equation for the power generation. Base impedance can be calculated. That's the formula. The base voltage square divided by base of ON. And rated current is the base voltage divided by root 3 base voltage. Okay, this problem is 250 megavolt and 25 kV 3-phase steam turbine. Generator has a synchronous reactance for the 1 by 6 bar unit and a transient reactance HDT on the 0 by 23 bar unit. It delivers a rated output at a power factor of 100%. A short circuit suddenly occurs on the line close to the generation station. So calculate is a base impedance B, rated voltage drop C, transient reactance D, initial short circuit current E, steady state value of the current at the short circuit. Okay, firstly we calculate that's a base impedance. So the formula is the base voltage squared divided by the base voltage. So base voltage already given here 25 kilovolt. So this is with substitute 25,000. And base voltage is 250 MVA. So 250 into 10^6. So that we divide 25,000 squared divided by 250 into 10^6, you got a 2.50. Also that we can also calculate the rated current. So that this is the base voltage divided by root 3 sub base voltage. So base voltage is 250 into 10^6, root 3 1/7321. Base voltage is 25 into 10^3. So we calculate the 5771 MVR. So in this case, we can also calculate the synchronous reactance. So synchronous reactance is 1/6 bar unit. So 1 bar unit is equal to the 2.5 ohm. So the 1/6 bar unit is 1/6 multiplied 2.5, you got the 4 ohm. And rated voltage drop can also be calculated. Rated current multiplied by synchronous reactance. So rated current is 5771 ohm. Synchronous reactance is 4 ohm. So you got a 231,000 ohm. And in the meantime, the transient reactance can also be calculated. Transient reactance is HDT is 0.23 per unit. So 1 per unit is equal to this 4 ohm. So the 0.23 is 0.23 multiplies 2.5. 1 per unit is equal to 2.5 ohm. So the 0.23 is 0.23 multiplied 2.5 to 0.575 ohm. And then we can also calculate this rated voltage, base voltage by phase. So that here is we can get this base voltage. Line is 25 kilovolt. Divide by root 3, so 40.4 kilovolt. Then we calculate this EF. EF is a generator voltage. The generator voltage calculate the equation is the square root of base voltage square plus R into AS square. So base voltage is a per phase square is we already know that 40.4 volt. So 40.4 kilovolt we substitute. And also this the rated voltage draw is 23.1 kilovolt. So then we calculate square root of 40.4 square plus the 23.1 square. So you got a 27.2 kilovolt. And then we can also calculate the initial short circuit current. The formula is a supply voltage divided by the, this is for the reactance. So transient reactance. So supply voltage EF is a 27.2 into 10^3. And this is the transient reactance HDT is a 0.575. So we substitute, so you got a 47300 MVR. So this is for the transient initial short circuit current. And steady state short circuit current is the generator voltage divided by total reactance. So generator voltage is 272,000 divided by the 4. So you got a 6800 MVR. So this is for the calculation of the power generation. The calculation of this the transient current, short circuit current, and the steady state short circuit current. Okay, the next topic is a generator's control of flow. So this problem, an isolated 75 MVA synchronous generator feeds its own load and operates initially at 30,000. So this is a so an isolated 75 MVA synchronous generator feed its own load and operate initially at the 30,000 RPM, 50 Hz. A 20 megawatt load is suddenly applied and the steam bar to the turbine commands to open after 0.1 second to the dielet in the governor system. So calculate the frequency to which the generator body draws before the steam flow meets the new load. The stored energy for the machine is 4 kilowatt second per kVA. So this is for the generator system here. So this is boiler, while the producers are spinning, so let's say passing through the turbine, so turbine rotate and turbine and the generator carpet or generator produce the body. So this is shared on the station that we utilize the TECO generator. TECO meters are control the spin bar. So this is for the spin bar control system. So in this case, we firstly had to calculate the equation is that the frequency is equal to square root of no load stored energy minus applied loads are energy divided by the no load stored energy multiplied by the rated frequency. So this equation. So this equation, so that in this case our rated frequency we already know that 50 stars per second. We can substitute. And the no load stored energy need to be calculated. The formula is no load stored energy is equal to that this is for the kilowatt second per kV multiplied by machine capacity. So that is the 4 kilowatt second per kVA multiplied by machine capacity. Machine capacity is 75 MVA, 75 newton power 3. We call it 300 newton power 3. So this is the no load stored energy we can calculate like this. Apply load energy. So apply load energy is already given as 10 megawatt. So apply load energy is 10 megawatt. So apply load energy is 20 megawatt multiplies power multiplied time. The power is 20 kilowatt, 20 to 3 kilowatt, multiplied with 0.5 second. So this is the time is 0.5 second. Since our command to open after 0.5 second, so the time is 0.5 second, and that's a 20 megawatt load. 20 megawatt is 20 to 3 kilowatt. So we calculate so 10 to 3 kilojoule. So this is the applied load energy. So that we already know that no load slow energy 300 to 3, applied load energy 10 to 3. So square root of 300 to 3 minus 10 to 3 divided by 300 to 3 multiplied by 50, you got the 49.2. Half.